السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين وبعد أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل كما قال سبحانه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل آمين يا رب العالمين It's truly a blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal that He subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed or blessed certain times over the others, certain days over the other, as the best part of the day is the last third of the night, when every night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down to the first heaven and says, is there anyone who is asking for forgiveness so I can forgive him? Is there anyone who asks for something so I can give that to him? It happens every night, that's the best part of the day. The best day of the week is the day of Friday. The best month of the year is the month of Ramadan. The best nights of the year are the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, and among that is the night of Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, is called the best night of the year. Likewise, brothers, we have another opportunity coming up, which is called the best days of the year. Subhanallah, the best days of the year. The month of Ramadan passed, you know, it's been a couple of months now, and maybe, you know, we are feeling that the level of Iman is not that high as we sometimes feel in the month of Ramadan. Here is another opportunity that is coming up, right? You know, in the next week, maybe starting from Tuesday or Wednesday, starting with the first of Dhulhijah, will be these first 10 days of the month of Dhulhijah are called the best days of the year. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهِنَّ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ الْعَشَرِ قالوا ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله ولم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said there are no other days in which the deeds are more beloved to Allah عز وجل than these best 10 days of the Hijjah. He was asked ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله, not even the jihad fi sabilillah, not even for of a person who is out there in the battlefield and ready to sacrifice his life. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wala al-jihad fi sabilillah, not even the jihad fi sabilillah, except for a person who leaves his house, his man, his wealth, and with himself, binafsihi wa malihi, wa lam yarji' min dhalika bi shay', and he does not return back with either of it, meaning that he is martyr, he is shaheed in the way of Allah azza wa jal. Except for that person, brothers, the best 10 days of the year are coming up. Now why they are, you know, called the best days? There are certain fada'il of those 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijjah. Imam Al-Qalani, rahimahullah, the one who is the author of the famous book Fath al-Bari, which is the tashreef, the sharah of Sahih al-Bukhari, he says that the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, all the five pillars of Islam, the shahada, the fasting, the prayer, the zakah, and the hajj, you know, you can fulfill all those five pillars of Islam in these first 10 days of the year, and there are no other days of the year that you can do that. And you know, the hajj cannot be performed in any other day of the year, except starting from the 8th of Dhul-Hijjah. Likewise, we pray during those 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. We are recommended to fast in those 10 days of the year. We spend in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. We are recommended to say the Shahada, La ilaha illallah, also in those 10 days of the Dhul-Hijjah. So these days are so important. And look at in Surah Al-Fajr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the oath of these 10 days of the year by saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim wal-Fajr, by the dawn, wa layalin ashr, and by 10 nights. Including Ibn Kathir rahimahullah and many other Mufassireen, they have the opinion here, this Layalin Ashr means the best 10 days, the best 10 days of the year. Also, during these first 10 days of the year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed this religion. That ayah, Al-Yawma Akmaltu Lakum Deenakum Wa Atmamtu Alaykum Ni'mati Wa Raditu Lakum Al-Islam Deena, was revealed. And as you know, a Jewish man, he came to Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, and he said, there's an ayah, there's a part of the verse in the Quran that you guys even read. If it would have revealed on us, we would have celebrated that day. And then he recited this ayah, and Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said, Wallahi, by Allah, I know when and where it was revealed on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was the day of Arafah. It was the day of Arafah when it was revealed on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum. Today I have completed my religion for you. Also, we know that the appointment of Musa alayhi salam with Allah azza wa jalla, as Allah mentioned Surah Al-A'raf, وَوَاعَدْنَا مُوسَى ثَلَاثِينَ لَيْلًا. We had an appointment with Musa alayhi salam for 30 nights. And then Allah says, وَأَتْمَمْنَاهَا بِعَشْرٍ فَتَمَّ مِيقَاتُ رَبِّهِ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلًا. Then 10 days were added. So the scholars, they have the opinion, those 30 nights were the nights of Dhul-Qa'dah, and the added 10 days were the month of Dhul-Hijjah. Likewise, the day of Arafah, which is so important. Day of Arafah is called, you know, the day of Hajj as well. The day of the dua is also in these first 10 days of the month of Dhulhijjah. Now the question is, brothers, what we can do in these best 10 days of the year? You know, when we talk about the month of Ramadan, what is the slogan of the month of Ramadan? شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed. The slogan of the month of Ramadan is to read, recite the Quran as many times as we can. What is the slogan of these best 10 days of the year? So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that as well, that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِنَّ مِنَ التَّسْبِيحِ وَالتَّحْمِيدِ وَالتَّهْلِيلِ. These three things we have to do it, you know, often in these, especially in these first 10 days of Dhulhijjah. Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu and many other ashab, they used to go, you know, in the streets of Medina, and out loud they used to recite this tasbih, which means Subhanallah. Saying Subhanallah a lot, tasbih, wa tahmeed, alhamdulillah, wa takbir, la ilaha illallah. So the slogan of these first 10 days of Dhulhijjah is Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Frequently we should say this out loud, you know, starting from, especially from the first day of Dhulhijjah. This should be the slogan of these first 10 days of the year. And before that also, brothers, you know, it's been said that the more we are prepared for anything, the better result we will have. Likewise, we have 3 or 4 days left before we start, inshallah, the first of Dhulhijjah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us, first of all, to witness these 10 days of the year, the best 10 days of the year. And when we receive those, we ask Allah azza wa jal to give us tawfiq to do our the best, inshallah, in these best 10 days of the year. How we can start? Before that, what is one of the recommended things that we should do? And that is the tawbah. Brothers, the tawbah, repentance. We all commit sins here and there, left and right. So one of the best way to enter in these best 10 days of the year is to have to do this sincere repentance, the tawbah and nasuha, before we enter in the month of Dhulhijjah. Because preparing the heart, you know, for the ubudiyyah, for the ibadah of Allah Azza wa Jal, is so important. So we can get more benefit out of those 10 days. So repentance, returning back to Allah Azza wa Jal with sincere heart, with the tawbah and nasuha, is one of the, can be one of the very effective way, inshallah, to enter in these blessed 10 days of the best 10 days of the year. Likewise, Hajj can only be performed in these first, or starting from the 8th of the Hijjah. Unfortunately, this year we might not be able to perform the Hajj, especially only the local people will be able to. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make it easy, that the time that we are going through, we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to let us be out of these difficult times, inshallah. And that we, but at the same time, it's a reminder for all of us that sometimes, you know, the blessings that we enjoy, we don't recognize those blessings. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes take away that blessings, sometimes, you know, as a human being, we do realize that the blessing of health, the blessing of wealth, so many blessings that we are enjoying. And this is one of the reflections that we can have from this time, is those blessings that normally we enjoy and maybe we don't recognize. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us, inshallah. Standing in night prayer, especially in these 10 days of the month of Ramadan, of the best 10 days of the year, is another recommended thing. Because if at night we are praying, we are standing in qiyam, Allah Azza wa Jalla will give us a tawfiq to do our best, inshallah, during the daytime as well. Overall also, brothers, increasing the good deeds, increasing our sadaqah in these 10 days of the year. Let me repeat that hadith of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, which he said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهِنْ. There are no other days in which the deeds are most beloved to Allah than these 10 days of the year. So your sadaqah, your spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your recitation of the Quran, your fasting. Fasting is another recommended action for these first 9 days of the first 9 days of Dhulhijjah, because the 10th is the day of Eid in which we cannot fast. But the first 9 days of the month of Dhulhijjah, it is recommended that we should fast, especially the fasting of the day of Arafah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a person who fasts for the day of Arafah, the 9th of Dhulhijjah, his sins of the previous sins and upcoming year will be forgiven by Allah Azza wa Jal. Likewise, ta'alluq bil Quran is another recommended action that we should do, especially in these first 10 days of the year. Why not maybe to recite 3 juz every day in these first 10 days of the year, and to complete another Quran inshallah. Reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always gives a benefit to thee and the light to the believer. And one last thing, brothers, especially for those, of course, another action for these 10 days of the year is the sacrifice, the udhiyah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lived in Medina for 10 years and he never missed udhiyah, a sacrifice. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you tawfiq to do it, inshallah, do that sacrifice to fulfill the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you are willing, if you have the intention to do so, remember this sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as well, that starting from the Maghrib of the first of Dhulhijjah, if you have intention to sacrifice an animal, you should not cut your nails, neither you should cut your hairs. So try and make sure that you do it before the start of the first day of the Maghrib, of the first day of Dhulhijjah. And Umm Salama radiallahu anha, she narrates a hadith saying that the meaning of the hadith, that if a person has the intention to sacrifice an animal, he should not cut his nails, neither any hairs of his body part, starting from the Maghrib of the first of Dhulhijjah, which will be starting from inshallah coming Tuesday or Wednesday. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq to do our deepest inshallah in these first 10 days of the year. Especially remember the slogan of these first 10 days of the year is tasbih, tahmeed and tahleel, saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون. قال سبحانه: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا كاملا ويقينا صادقا ورزقا واسعا ولسانا ذاكرا وقلبا خاشعا وتوبة نصوحا قبل الموت وراحة عند الموت والعفو عند الحساب والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم إنا نسألك خير ما سألك منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما. ربنا تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم، وتب علينا انك انت التواب الرحيم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأجل وأتم وأهم وأكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.